We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Fishkill Issue 2. This is a 2020 miniseries from Heavy Metal, created and written by Dan Fogler and Laurence Blum. Cover and interior art and lettering by Ben Templesmith. Editing and production and content management by Justin Mulman. I finally found a copy of this. Took me a long time to track down the second issue. This is a very short print run, but we have jumped forward a few days and it looks like somebody has framed Fishkill as the bomber. And they're saying 3,000 dead. I don't know how there were 3,000 people on that bridge, but this does take place in the future, so who knows. Fishkill, however, has woken up and he is in what appears to be the sewer or somewhere like that. He's injured, but he's been injured worse. Unfortunately, he is very, very low on his antipsychotic medicines, so he is hearing voices and seeing things that may not be there. Now, he saw the explosion, so he knows that something's up, and he thinks that the bomber got away. Now, we get some flashbacks about how his dad used to beat him. And he has definitely a screwed up family life, but it also looks like the mayor or some higher up's daughter's missing and he's offering a $1 billion reward. So people are out looking for that. The police are out confiscating weapons and marking houses that are unarmed, which of course brands them with giant targets on their back. But the police have no problem doing it. They even reference how they did this in New Orleans during Katrina as justification to prevent damage. But we learn a lot of interesting things along the way. There are a lot of people out looking for that girl, including this guy's son, who apparently may be involved in this catastrophe. So it looks like the higher-ups know more than they are letting on, and Fishkill might be the only chance of uncovering the truth, and surviving it is going to be kind of a struggle. But we get a really interesting cliffhanger ending. This was a really good issue. I'm not a big fan of Ben Templesmith's art, never have been, but if you like his style and you like his work on, like, 30 Days of Night and other stuff, you'll probably like it. The color is really, really good, and it does add a lot to this. So I would absolutely recommend this. The story is a lot of fun. It's really interesting. I'm not a fan of the art style, but I know that it is a popular style for his diehard followers. So if you like Ben Templesmith's art, you're going to love this. But a fun crime noir book with a very, very bizarre twist. So worth checking out, though, because the story is really interesting. There is one thing that troubled me about it, though, is that they do use real-world logos for the news reporters, which is usually a big no-no, because those are trademarks. But they've got Fox News, CNN, and NBC's in here. And I'm kind of surprised they did that, because that's how you get sued. So I don't think they got permission to do that, but I would definitely be cautious of that if you're creating a book, not to use real-world logos like that. That's why they use fake ones, because they don't want to get sued or pay licensing fees. So that's just something, just a side note on that one. But that'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel out in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.